show. If you like good old-fashioned entertainment, you have come to the right place, because we have something for everybody.
That's right, just like Josh said, this is a New Dawn Day, and we are so excited to be here tonight with all of you. We put together many different styles of songs that we're sure you're going to recognize, plus some surprises up our sleeve.
That's right, so sit back, relax, and enjoy as we take you on this
it's When you think of American recreation and amusement, one of the main subjects you might think of is baseball. The earliest mention of baseball in the United States was back in 1791, and throughout the many years that this beloved game has been played, some amazing, some heartbreaking, and also some hilarious moments have occurred. Such as in 1923 when Clarence Bleeden bit himself while stealing second base with his own false teeth that he forgot that he had put in the back pocket of his trousers. Or in 1982 when Joel Youngblood recorded a hit for two different teams in two different cities all on the same day. And who could forget Babe Ruth, who hit a record 714 home runs in 22 seasons. Well, whether you're a lifelong fan or just like to go to the ballgame for some peanuts and Cracker Jacks, you can't deny that baseball is one of America's favorite pastimes. We'd like to have you join us out on the field. Grab a hot dog and get ready to cheer on your favorite team. With one, two, three strikes, we're heading out to the old ballgame.
Like the Constitution, the institution of dear old baseball, where every man is treated.
are. Now, I have a question for you. By show of hands, was there anyone in the audience who was even around during the 1970s? That's what I thought. Well, the 1970s brought us bell bottoms, funky hairstyles, and groovy bass lines, as well as music groups such as the Village People, the Bee Gees, Donna Summer, Gloria Gaynor, the Jackson 5, and that famous group of four named ABBA, as well as many other musical artists that we've come to know and love. It also brought us films such as Saturday Night Fever and a whole new style of dancing that the world had never seen before, such as the Bump, the Hustle, and the Boogaloo. The music of the 70s still hits the radio charts today and is a shared favorite by many across the world. It was a decade all its own, and we'd like to bring you back in time just a little to the days when life was a bit more simple, a bit more groovy, and a whole lot of disco!
Yeah.
II, there was a group of three sisters that would sing together for the military troops with close harmonies and melodies. Of course, I'm talking about the Andrew sisters. Patty, the youngest sister, was only 7 when the group was first formed, and just 12 when they won their first talent contest. Laverne used to play piano at the local Orpheum Theater in Minneapolis in exchange for free dance lessons for herself and her sisters. After the collapse of their father's restaurant, they began touring to support their family when they soon found themselves moving to California and becoming very well known. Their vocal blend was unique, and they went on to make films, records, and commercial jingles, as well as radio and TV performances. They continue to be a favorite even today, and we would now like to do our tribute to the Andrew Sisters. Known as the Boardwalk of Atlantic City. The Roaring Twenties brought much excitement to this area. Stunts, shows, gaming, and the world-famous saltwater taffy are just some of the things that one might find when walking down the boardwalk, as well as the original Miss America pageant. Well, we would like to take you there, so grab your hat and grab your parasol and come with us as we head out to the seashore to visit Atlantic City.
In your own words, what would make this world a better place?
I would have to say world peace.
Contestant number two, in your own words, what would make this world a better place?
I would have to say world peace.
Contestant number three, in your own words, what would make this world a better place?
Harsher punishments for parole violators.
And world peace.
Let's see.
You love a friend, but being for friends, that
night. Through the years, the theme from Cheers, moving right along.
Thanks, Kate.
There's one more.
Yeah?
I have to say I love you in a song.
That's so sweet! I've never gotten such a nice present from a guy.
Well, I'm glad you like it. You see, now I have to go make one for everybody else.
Tricky Monster and Rodney and Christmas Eve and everyone.
Kate?
Yeah?
What are you doing tonight?
Grading term papers, but they're for kindergarten, so very short. Why?
Well, you see, a bunch of us are going to the Round the Clock Cafe tonight, and do you want to come with me?
Like a date?
Yeah, like a date. It'll be a
blast.
I'd love to come.
Yes. Well, that's great. I'll see you then. Are you bye?
Such a great audience. Now the words American music can cover so many different styles, it's hard to narrow it down to just one or two. But no show would be complete without a tribute to that city that never sleeps and has lights up and down the entire street, illuminating the way to entertain it at its best. Yes, I'm talking about Broadway. In the heart of New York City, it sits in the middle of all the bustle, new shows year after year, featuring some of the world's most talented performers. Glittering costumes, catchy melodies, heartwarming storylines, Broadway has it all, and something for everyone to enjoy. In fact, on this street, even the car horns seem to harmonize. To see a show here is an experience like no other. Next, we're going to take you up front and center stage as we bring the shows to you. If you hear a song that you like and have seen, we invite you to applaud so that we know it's a favorite of yours. Please feel free to join in and sing along with us. Now don't worry, you won't mess us up. We know our parts. So, sit back and enjoy the music of Broadway.
Thank you. Hey, folks. We're so very glad to be back. I just take a minute now to thank you and to tell how much I appreciate your beautiful new facilities. I see our room got redecorated here a little bit, and I noticed the dining room is, you can eat all the good food with good surroundings, and you can enjoy yourself in the hallway, a little cafe there as you walk in. I wasn't sure I was in the right building when I showed up, but we're glad that you're doing well here, and I hope that you have a good, prosperous summer. New York Singers come from a little town, some of you are new to us, a little town in Florida called Eustis, Florida. Now, some people call it useless, but it's Eustis, and we're there, and that's where our headquarters at this point lies, and it's about 40 miles north of Orlando. Our people come, really, from all parts of the country, one from Oregon and Illinois, and there is somebody from Florida that's kind of unusual. Half of our, maybe a little more than half of our members work at Disney full-time, and right now we're a part-time singing group for some odd things that have happened, but we're glad we're here on this trip to the north. It's north for us anyway. And then tomorrow we have a concert, and then we head back down to south, and we'll do some other things for the summer. We're glad we're here sharing good old-fashioned American music. Now, we have a wonderful package coming up, and we'll be through here in about 3 hours, so don't worry, it won't get too late. I'm kidding. Sorry to take me seriously. We have a package of songs that you're going to enjoy. It's a little trip around the country, and then one final song, and then we'll be finished. But once again, we're thankful that we're here, and I hope that you're enjoying the show. Now let's get on with the show. Thank you.
If someone was asked to describe America, they would most likely answer liberty, freedom, justice, or some other term or phrase that we as a nation of individuals get to experience in our everyday lives. But few of us actually get to see all the other amazing scenic landscapes and features that can be found in each of the 50 states. If we could travel around our country, we would learn how rich we are in diverse cultures and backgrounds, how beautiful we are in our national forests and state parks, and how plentiful we are in our resources. We truly are a blessed nation. Of course, we have our differences, but we can all agree that we still are the most treasured country on this planet. We would like to invite you now to join us on a trip across America. Now, we will cover every single state and talk about their incredible facts and features. And as we do, when we come across your home state or even a state that you might have family in, we ask that you give a cheer real loud so that we know that you're proud of where you're from. This is your chance to clap, cheer, and sing along to the songs that bring you back home. So let's celebrate as we take a trip across the 50 states of America.
Chesapeake Bay come the best lobster and crab.
serene Shenandoah Valley, nestled in the foothills of the Appalachian and Blue Ridge Mountains.
I'm south of Dixie.
you again, Brandon.